Nobody enjoys sitting in traffic. There are a lot of ways to deal with traffic. You can build more roads or beef up mass transit. But today, we're going to talk about getting around traffic by getting small. The fundamental nature of traffic changes when cities and citizens start adopting electric bikes, e-scooters, and small delivery vehicles. My name's Matt, and here's what you need to know about micromobility. The word micromobility is an umbrella term. It covers several different transportation trends that have one thing in common. The vehicles involved are smaller than the cars we're used to seeing on the road. They can be gas-powered or even human-powered, but increasingly, we're talking about battery-powered electric vehicles. They can include electric skateboards, bicycles, cargo bikes, scooters, mopeds, motorbikes, and tricycles. Micromobility systems include cars that are much smaller than the average automobile. Japan has one of the longest histories with tiny vehicles. They call them K-cars. There have always been small cars in Europe, but now Europe has microcars. Called quadricycles, some are even smaller than K-cars. So far, we've been talking about micromobility in terms of personal vehicles, but it also involves small commercial vehicles. That includes rickshaws used as taxis, and it includes delivery vehicles, such as cargo bikes and tiny trucks. Some market researchers include small, autonomous delivery robots in the micromobility market, too. Micromobility options are attractive for a lot of reasons. Smaller vehicles minimize traffic congestion. They can take advantage of sidewalks and alleys that are inaccessible to full-size motor vehicles. Smaller vehicles are greener. They minimize or eliminate carbon emissions. In urban environments especially, smaller cargo vehicles can get closer to final delivery destinations. And of course, any vehicle that can be pedaled, with or without a power boost from electric batteries, is great exercise. Estimates of the size of the global micromobility market all differ, but it's certainly in the hundreds of billions of dollars. Whatever the number is, most expected to triple by the 2030s. But before that rapid growth really kicks in, the market is going to have to work through some issues. While micromobility is a great idea, the rollout could have been better. Micromobility solutions can be too small and too slow to operate safely in ordinary traffic. At the same time, many pedestrians consider them to be too fast and too dangerous on sidewalks and footpaths. Some of the cities that initially embraced micromobility, including Melbourne, Paris, and San Francisco, have slammed on the brakes. Now, city and state governments around the world are considering how to pave the way for micromobility solutions, literally with dedicated pathways and figuratively with rules and regulations. The battery systems in almost every type of micro vehicle have very good safety records. Almost. The batteries in vehicles at the lower end of the market, especially some e-bikes, have been unacceptably prone to catching fire. So engineers are improving the battery management systems. IC manufacturers have also introduced safety devices. Two examples are negative temperature coefficient thermistors to monitor battery temperatures, and battery protectors that cut the circuit when an overvoltage is detected. With new regulations and ongoing technological innovation, the micromobility market is expected to resume its rapid growth. To learn more about micromobility, check out this article linked in the description below. You're also welcome to browse our technical library with articles on a wide range of subjects. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up with what you need to know.